Today, what many of us would love to believe is that the internet is a private place. It's not. And with every click of the mouse and every touch of the screen, we are like Hansel and Gretel, leaving breadcrumbs of our personal information everywhere we travel through the digital woods.
There's a big difference between online advertising at all and this incredibly intrusive practice of collecting your reading habits without your consent.
Google's collecting this information, including things that people say they do not want. All the surveys of consumers suggest they'd rather not be tracked over the internet.
It's about improving relevance. It's about using information that you've shared with Google to make Google products and services more useful for you. What we want to do is we want to deliver products that delight users and that they find extremely useful.
I think the problem here is that we aren't informed about this trade-off. I think some of us would be totally willing to trade our data for free content, and some people wouldn't. And I think most people are just not aware that they're striking that bargain.
If you post your pictures on a public website like this, people can grab them without you even knowing it. Some companies are cruising sites like Flickr looking for free images to use in ad campaigns.
Allison Chang of Bedford, Texas, discovered her picture being used by Virgin Mobile Australia for an advertising campaign. The tricky part is she never agreed to be the model.
There's a big myth out there that young people don't care about privacy, and that is about as inaccurate as you can get.